Many do not have adequate housing.
Or even a bed to sleep on.
Or possibly not even a roof over their head.
This year, someone close to you struggling with mental illness and behavioral health challenges needs your support.
But you can help make the difference.
We believe in seeing the need and finding the solution with stories of healing and hope. Log on to AZTV.com or STNAZ.TV for your chance to win prizes that can change your life.
Happy holidays.
Welcome to Seeing the Need, Finding the Solution, Stories of Healing and Hope 2011, free medical care for people in the Valley that do not have insurance. We've been running a promotion here. Commercials have started, so you'll see some stuff on TV kind of promoting that as well as different areas around town, jobbing.com up on the front of the billboard, you'll see that as well, and some different radio promos coming up on Cool FM. I'm just going to read it before I introduce my guest today, a couple of the responses that we've already have received this year. You just saw a Dutch Bros commercial, by the way, one of our sponsors and longtime sponsors. They have coming up here this week on December the 9th, a Bucks for Kids Day. Proceeds will go to benefit Boys and Girls Club. Go ahead and check out Dutch Bros. Go to DutchBros.com, look for the nine Valley locations, or I think it's eight or nine. They got so many of them popping up. But really, really great organization, and better than that, great coffee as well, which keeps me awake and keeps you guys safe while I'm on here. So one of the stories is there's two things going on, giving away a home makeover that we do every year, but as equally important and probably more so is the health care and the whole care of individuals and citizens in our valley. As you can see, free health care giveaway up there and sponsored by People of Color Network, your neighborhood health care centers, and a lot of sponsors, as you can see, that are getting involved to be involved in the community. One of the stories here, I'm just going to read a couple different excerpts from this, is the lady writes in and talks about her son, who is 36 years old, has mental and learning disabilities, which makes getting a good job, a good paying job, very difficult. 11-year-old daughter as well, and is the apple of his eye. Very overweight and borderline diabetes with a little child, and house is in not good condition as well. And the final answer on this is would be a very beautiful answer to the prayers for the son and the daughter. And the next one I really liked, it hit the other end of the spectrum, was I want to win for my grandmother. She's 80 years old. She has lived on her property since she was 19 years old. She's the most giving person, even to this day, that I have ever known. She gives so much to her family and the community, even at 80 years old, that she has very little left for herself, and her house is falling apart. So those are the kind of aspects of different stuff that we're talking about when you log on to stnaz.tv or aztv.com, Stories of Healing and Hope. You can use the same registration form for healthcare as well. But that's what we want. We want to find that one family that really could benefit from that free health care, and as well as maybe giving them a blessing and a nice Christmas present, which comes with an NFL Cardinals experience. With that in pocket, introduce you to the CEO of People of Color Network, Mr. Tomas Leon.
Hey,
welcome, Tomas.
Thank you.
Let you jump in as usual. Tomas is now the host of the show, and I'm the secondary now. Tomas, if you go ahead and start in and then introduce your guest, we'll go from there.
Okay. Well, every time I come on, I feel like I bring a valued partner of our network, and today is no exception. We're here to hear and learn from Viva Esperanza, and translated in English, Hope Lives. And they're a peer-run, community-based organization. And they were created recently by key partners that came together to see the need and find a solution. And Viva Esperanza is the solution. And Magellan Health of Arizona provided the funding for us to incubate and start up this organization. Valle del Sol and Kurt Shepherd, their new CEO, has been instrumental in providing technical assistance, and we've been supportive in starting up the organization. And so we're delighted to be partners and affiliated with them, and they're providing a valuable service in our community, especially as we move forward with our focus on whole health services, meeting the whole needs of a person, the mind, the body, and the spirit, and our endeavor to integrate behavioral health and physical health services. So I'm going to stop there because I want to hear what they have to say and hear one of the stories that are coming out of the organization.
Awesome. Christopher Gonzalez, CEO of Hope Lives, Vive la Esperanza. Or Viva La Esperanza, Hope yeah. Lives. Chris, you know, we just spoke yesterday, and I was doing some different research on your website. You're talking about providing whole health services, skill-building services for mm-hmm. seriously mentally ill. Let's talk, I'm going to have you share a little bit about that, and we'll jump into Michelle over here, who's kindly come on the show to give us her experience, her strength, and her hope as well.
Okay. Well, not only do we focus on the whole health and holistic model for a person with the mind, body, and spirit, but we also try to reduce comorbidity rates and really look at the whole health perspective that we focus on in supporting managed care for that person. And we really like to take this up to another level and look at the self-determination through that person's individual control and choice, and then kind of bring it together as a whole community.
To allow them to grow at their pace as
Absolutely.
Well. Awesome. In addition to that, the one of the things that was, things that I did research on was, I was really impressed was, you know, there's a, you have a thing on service, to serve, to educate, and to train. And everywhere from workshops on fatherhood, a techie camp.
Yes.
By the way, we have a computer sponsor that would probably be a nice fit for you as well. But just a little bit of what goes on over at Viva La Esperanza, Hope Lives, interpersonal communication workshops, parenting, techie camps, and that is provides instruction to computer components for mm-hmm. kids, how to take computers apart and applications and different things like that. Also support services, GED study programs, restoration of civil rights as well, which is really, really mm-hmm. important. First aids, there's the number on the screen of 855-747-6522. You can go to the website also at vivehopelives.org for a boatload of information, which I saw this weekend. With that in pocket, I'd like to introduce Ms. Michelle Nyman. Mm-hmm. How you doing, Michelle?
Hi.
Michelle's gonna, I'm gonna start off this. I have shared my story for years, so I'll lead in the way, the only way I know how. What was it like? A peer support program, first of all, for those of you who don't know, is basically based on somebody who's went through a whole bunch of stuff, wound up coming out on an end of it to where they can actually be in a position to work for a company and help others that have gone through the same thing or something similar as well. And for somebody that's in that position, to relate to somebody is so very important. What was it like before you got involved with Viva La Esperanza?
That's a really large question. Well, before I was a peer support for Viva La Esperanza, I was also a peer support within the system for 4 years. I worked at the urgent psychiatric care facility. And before that, I had been studying to get my PhD at the university. When I began to have some issues with my mental health challenges, which made it impossible for me to finish that program. People were not, it was a while ago, and so the education component really wasn't there. Even at the university, they didn't understand really what was going on with me. And so at that point, I was asked to leave the PhD program and told that I did not have the personality to get a PhD.
So let me get this right. So you suffer from a mental illness.
I do.
And trying to get a PhD nonetheless, and 86th out of it and left with going, what do I do now?
Yeah, and okay. At that point, I became agoraphobic for 5 years. I did not leave my house for 5 years.
Wow.
However, even though I didn't leave my house, I was able to work because I have some skills that made it possible for me to interpret over the phone. So I was kind of resilient in that way. I was able to even though I had some things that I really didn't feel comfortable doing, I was able to interpret, I was able to do some things and able to kind of keep myself afloat. I had a house, I had some things that I was able to keep. So.
And didn't give up either.
Correct, no. It was pretty devastating because that had been my goal, to get my PhD and to be teaching at the university. That had been my goal for a very long time. And so when that was no longer, or at least I felt that was no longer a possibility, it was pretty devastating for me. And so I just shut myself off from the world. And however, doing that brought me consequences that I soon realized I didn't want anymore, which was that I didn't have a life. So then I began trying to crawl out of the hole I had kind of dug for myself. And I was able to do that. I was very lucky. I had some people in my life that were very supportive and made it possible for they walked beside me while I began to do that.
So we've got about 3 minutes. You have now got some people that walk in beside you.
Mm-hmm.
You've got support. You've been through hell and back. Defining moment. Past the, I don't know if it was State Psychiatric Hospital or in that realm, but past that point, I want to really focus on your experience with Viva Esperanza.
Okay.
Defining moment there and how that has helped you in your life.
Working as a peer support with Viva Esperanza.
With people who are still suffering.
Well, I think an essential function of peer support is to help, but being a peer support is also a way for people to help themselves in a way too, because there's an interchange of ideas, there's an interchange of experiences, and it doesn't just go one way. So just like hopefully I have something to bring to the table to people that I interact with as a peer support, they bring very much to me also.
And that's what it's about.
Yeah.
It's kind of like recovery. You know, it's based on what was freely given to us that we give back to another human being. And that gift is double-sided. I know, at least on my end, what you're giving to that person is such a value to them, but what you're getting in return is also helping you to keep going as well. For those people out there who are still suffering, pick up the phone. Call the phone number. Go to the website, stnaz.tv, go to aztv.com, fill out the registration form, free health care. If you have a situation where you're in a home for a lot of years or you're in a situation to where you need some help, make the phone call. There's companies like Chris's out there that will help you, and there's companies like Tomas's out there that will help you. Go to POCN.com as well. Look at the services. We'll be more than happy to try to get you connected on the shows everywhere from St. Joseph's Hospital to People of Color Network to Viva La Esperanza, Hope Lives, and a whole bunch of other areas as well. Stories of Healing and Hope. Log on. Tell us the story. Tell us what you are going through. Be bold. Share your story. What it does is it helps somebody saying, if they can do it, maybe I can do it. My name is Phil McElveen. This is Christmas 2011, Stories of Healing and Hope. Please log on to aztv.com or stnaz.tv, and we'll see you next week.